I have another inspiring Power BI story for you. Meet Jon Acampora, fellow Microsoft MVP and friend who left his full-time job as a financial analyst and built his online training business, ExcelCampus.com. It all started with Jon wanting to give back to the community. And now, 40,000 people every day learn from him through his website, YouTube channel, and online courses. Make sure you watch till the end as Jon shares how an introvert who took the slow turtle approach can still achieve great success if they learn this one key lesson. Stories like Jon that get me excited. Stories from real people just like you and me using Power BI to make a real impact. These are the Power BI pioneers. If this video inspired you in any way, please leave a comment and let me and Jon know. Make sure to subscribe and click the bell so you don't miss a thing. Let's hear it from Jon.
Hey, Jon, how are you doing?
Great. Thank you for having me. I'm excited.
Indeed. I'm so excited to have you here. I followed you online. So your main presence is on ExcelCampus.com. Is that right?
That's correct. ExcelCampus.com.
Awesome. And you're on YouTube as well, right? Fellow YouTuber?
Yeah, fellow YouTuber. YouTube channel is also ExcelCampus.
Oh, perfect. All right. So tell me the story of ExcelCampus. How did it come about?
It started a long time ago. Okay. In internet years, I think it was back in 2009, 2010. It was just kind of a hobby at that point, sharing some of the things that I was doing in Excel. A few add-ins that I created and also VBA type projects. So I just started a site to kind of share some of the things I've been creating and also kind of give back to the community that I learned from, because I'd really learned so much from just Google searches back then, for sure, and all the forums that people were, you know, posting in. It's really a place where I probably gained most of my knowledge with Excel.
Yeah, that's great. And where is ExcelCampus right now? So right now, it's not a part-time thing anymore. Yeah, tell me a little bit about where it is right now.
Yeah, now it is my full-time business. My full-time job is ExcelCampus. So it has grown a lot over the last 8 years or so, especially over the last 2 years. It's really taken off. We've seen a lot of growth from the YouTube channel and also from the blog as well. Full-time job, and of course we have courses, and I also sell some of the add-ins that I've developed for Excel. That's how I originally got started. Started selling some of those add-ins that I created for Excel, and then got into doing online courses as well.
That's great. Give me a sense of the scale. I don't know, whichever number pops at you or is going to be relevant, like, I don't know, visitors you get or something like that. How many people are you touching, right, reaching with this?
Yeah, and I just look at that, actually. And we're reaching on the weekdays almost 40,000 people a day visit either the YouTube channel or the website. So it's kind of hard to even fathom that number, but it really shows how many people are searching for help with these tools. Not just Excel, you know, Power BI as well. It shows, and I have like a very, very small piece of that pie when it comes to search. I don't have that much content. So it really goes to show just how many people are using these tools and also need help with them.
My man, that's brilliant. You said you started on this with the intent of giving back. Talk about that, right? I mean, 40,000 people. And so, of course, we've all heard that where somebody's listening and they're like, oh, my gosh, I only got 100 visitors. But imagine 100 people in room. Man, it's going to be pretty crowded if it's not a huge room. But imagine 40,000. That's a, you need a much bigger room. So that's great, man. I'm really glad for you.
Yeah, and of course, that took time, too. You know, it's been 8 years of doing this. And so it definitely takes time to get there, too.
Yeah, that's great. So I'll say when I first met you, I mean, you're so unassuming, very approachable, and that's great. But I would have almost, I don't know if you categorize yourself, do you think of yourself as introverted, extroverted? So where on that scale would you put yourself?
Oh, definitely introverted. Yeah, no doubt about it.
Wow. So if I know I have kind of struggled with that myself, and I hear others kind of say this, oh, I can't do this because I'm ABC, right? They fill something in. So when you were just starting out, or maybe a little bit before that, if somebody had shown you this glimpse, would you have kind of believed that, or would you have said, no, that doesn't sound like me?
No, I definitely would not have believed it. I think I even still have some of my old videos up on YouTube from like the very first ones I did. And, you know, it's, those are probably embarrassing now, but it's
we all
have a long way. And it took me time. It wasn't natural for me to want to do something like this, especially even just like getting on camera. Like it's not something I would have thought of years ago that I'd be doing and doing for a living. So for me personally, it took time to kind of break out of that shell and really enjoy it.
That's great. And of course, I mean, the way I see it, I mean, the way you come across as a person, you come across in your blog and certainly video, it's very transparent. You come across the same way. And I think that's the key. You're not going to turn into this gregarious showman suddenly, and you don't need to. You can succeed just by kind of being yourself. And yeah, that's very evident with your example.
Yeah, I think so. And I think a part of it is, and the nice part of it is, you get pretty instant feedback with even just creating a video and going back and listening to yourself or watching yourself, and you can critique yourself and improve very quickly, which is what I try and do, and still takes time to improve. Mm-hmm. But I do try and interject a little more energy into, you know, the videos and all that stuff now versus when I started. I was just trying to put all this stuff together.
You can always things we can do differently, but still be you, and that's what I enjoy about your content. So tell me a little bit more about the journey, about the transition. So it did take a long time, and I'm sure there were a lot of lessons learned along the way. Are there any key kind of insights that stand out, or key turning points in that process, in that whole journey?
Yeah, I think there are definitely a few. One was the shift in the products I was offering in terms of making this a full-time job for me. Mm-hmm. Of course, before that, I worked full-time at a day job and then did this ExcelCampus as a hobby, I guess you could say.
Yeah. I do want to hear that, but can you tell me a little bit more about the day job that you had? What were you doing?
Oh, sure. Yeah, so I always had jobs mostly as a financial analyst doing corporate finance type work. Budgeting, forecasting, even accounting stuff. And my specialty within that was systems automation or process automation. So I really enjoyed, of course, like creating VBA solutions, but also dashboard type solutions, a lot of more automated systems where when in the corporate world, we're dealing with a lot of different data sources, it's a matter of bringing all that together in a way that makes sense, automating all that to then analyze the data and present it.
Yeah, that's
where I really focused and was most excited about those roles, was doing the creative work with the automation.
And in a way, you're still helping that audience, right? I mean, you're solving it not just for a single team you're working with, now you're solving it kind of for everybody, right? Through your courses, through the add-ins. Can you give me a few more examples of the gotchas or the problems that this audience struggles with? And let's stake in the finance. Now, of course, you broaden your audience too much bigger than that. But if you stay in that finance realm, so combining multiple data sources, what were some of the other things that you remember struggling with way, way back when you were still had that full-time job?
Yeah, a lot of it is doing that same repetitive task over and over again. Creating everything in finance is deadline driven. So you're either on a monthly close, a quarterly close, you're publishing numbers. Yeah. So everything is deadline driven. So that means you have to get all these things done between, in a certain amount of time. And so that is probably a very big problem or pain point for most Excel users, is they might not know the best tools that are available to them, even within Excel, that can make that job faster. A simple example is a pivot table. And as we know, a pivot table is really the underlying feature of Power BI and these bigger tools. It all comes down to the simplicity of what a pivot table can do. And so if you don't know that tool, then you might spend hours writing formulas to create the same result without really, knowing that there's a faster way out there. Those types of issues, I think, are the biggest ones. Just the time-consuming work that can be done in Excel when you don't know a faster way. It's not necessarily anyone's fault. They just haven't learned it yet.
Huh? Yeah, that's great. So Matt, you've been doing this long enough. So 2009, I was experimenting with the what was Project Gemini back then. I wrote my first DAX measure, but of course, and so 2009 is when you started ExcelCampus. You'd been using Excel much further back, I think.
Yes.
And you've seen the whole journey. You've seen the arrival of Power Pivot and Power Query and Power BI. What's your take on all this? I mean, how do you see it?
Well, I love the tools, and I love the evolution of these tools and how quickly they're changing now. They're being updated monthly. And especially with Power BI and even Power Query and being improved by Microsoft, and there's full support there, which is just awesome. And I also love to see people starting to use these tools and just explore them and find them for the first time. I know when people see what Power Query can do for the first time, even the unpivot feature is something that we used to write macros for, and those macros are not easy. It's not an easy task to solve, especially as your data gets more complex, right? So simple things like that can save so much time. And then when you look at that and how you can then, that's just one small piece of a fully automated process, right? With bringing data in with Power Query, maybe from multiple sources, combining it, creating those relationships with Power Pivot, or, you know, it's all done in Power BI too. But I, to get back to your question, I think it's amazing that we now have these tools available to us.
Yeah.
And I definitely want to help more people learn about them because I think, you know, the user adoption is still relatively low and it's just don't know about it yet.
Yes. I will say, that part sometimes frustrates me when I think about what a small sliver of everybody using Excel who can benefit from it. I mean, let alone the guys who were like doing simple stuff and they shouldn't care about it. But if you take the population benefit from it, how small sliver of that knows about it? But having said that, I mean, I heard that in your tone. I love kind of watching that reaction when you're able to show it to somebody for the first time, like this is what Power Query, Power Pivot, Power BI can do, and see their eyes go wide.
Yeah.
You know, gosh, you know, I love that. So, that's great. So, so I kind of sidetracked you, but let's get back on that journey. So, you're talking about. So, tell me again, kind of the key points, key turning points, key lessons in that journey from working full time, starting ExcelCampus, and being here now, where you're helping thousands of people every day.
Yeah, sure. So, of course, the growth took time. That wasn't like an overnight lesson, I don't think. But one of those, again, one of the turning points was just offering courses, online courses, because I realized, of course, I saw other people in our industry doing that, but I also realized that people that are using Excel want to learn these techniques. Before that, I had been developing add-ins, which would just solve the problem with the click of a button in a lot of sense, you know, or just make tasks easier. And they still do, and they're still very popular, and people use them. But I think people also want to learn more about how to implement these things, maybe build their own add-ins. I have a course that teaches that.
Wow.
And really learn this so they can customize it to what they need. Because the thing with Excel and Power BI is that every single person that uses it is using it in a different capacity. They have different data, they have different results, they need different outputs, different KPIs. So therefore, they want to learn how they can use it for themselves and also maintain it, you know? So I think that was a big turning point for me, was realizing that I could be more of a teacher versus a developer.
Yeah. Wow. I'm sure a lot of people out there are glad, you know, you came to that and you made that switch. So let me end things on maybe a personal note. So I'm new to this journey. I left my job in Microsoft in 2014, but really been in my own business for about the past 2 years. And I want to ask you if besides, so there's, I'm sure in business, there's a lot you learn about the business, about running the business. You talked about the switch to courses, but sometimes you learn something about yourself as well. Is there something that comes to mind?
Yes. And first of all, congratulations on that jump for you. I know that's a big deal going through it myself.
Yeah.
So I just want to say congratulations to you. I think, you know, a lot of it is really having faith in yourself that it is possible to do this and take on a new venture in your life. Especially, you know, no matter what it is, it might be a new business. It might just be a new job that you want to try, a new career path. I've seen that even with some of my students. They've just taken a bit of that leap to do something that's way, you know, kind of above their, what they're doing now or their skill set now. And a lot of it's just having the faith and confidence to do that. You know, I think that's a, that might be kind of a generalization, but I think really it's one of the biggest drivers that can help with any level of success is really just believing in yourself and maybe having people around you that also believe in you too. I think that's another big one as well.
Yeah, that's great. So I'm going to push you a little bit more on that. So when you look back and like, oh, you know, I believe in myself, was it something external that changed, an event that happened? I mean, often we wait for that, right? Like, oh, when I get this promotion, then I'm going to be good enough. Or when I hit this much in annual revenue or something like that, or whatever, number of subscribers, right? I mean, we have some measure in our mind. Often we keep chasing that. Was it an event for you? And you're like, oh yeah, you know, look, this happened. I must be good enough. Or was it not? Was it internal?
Probably both. I'm trying to think. Some of it was that I met my wife.
Okay.
And she pushed me. She was that support that I was talking about for, you know, a lot of the transition there was her pushing me to go for it. Because honestly, you know, to get real personal, we were, she was pregnant at the time that I did quit my job and started working on ExcelCampus full time. So it was very scary to leave a job with benefits and health benefits and that stuff. At that time, you know, that stage in our life, but she was fully supportive of it. So it definitely helps to have that support. So I think that was one major thing. And I am a bit of a tortoise in the sense that it took me longer than it might take others. You, for example, you know, you just went for it, I feel, whereas I kind of slowly transitioned and made sure there was a safety net there. Looking back on it, I don't think I would do it that way, you know, or going forward, I might make decisions differently. But again, that just goes back to that faith and confidence to know that net will be there.
Yeah, that's true, man. Hey, thank you so much for sharing your keys to success and sharing everything about yourself. Thank you, man. It was great having you here.
Yeah, thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
All right, terrific.
Believe in yourself. It's simple, but not easy. That's what makes Jon a pioneer. If you would like to join other Power BI pioneers like Jon inside the Learn Power BI family, there's information in the details below. Until next time, power on, my friend.